Hey everybody, Joe here with Rogue Fabrication. Welcome to episode 3 of our BMW 2002 build. At the end of episode 2, we figured out that when the car was at ride height, the lower control arms were pointed up, which is not really great. Since we're building this car for the track, we want the suspension geometry to be right at a race ride height of only about 4 inches off the ground. So we're gonna raise that subframe up 2 inches into the frame. We already checked clearance with the engine. There is enough room to do it, but we've gotta notch the frame and then build boxes back on top of the frame to bring back that stock frame height and rigidity that we need for safety and everything else. So at the end of this episode, we're hoping to be able to check a little bit of steering clearance with tires against our firewall, kind of get a good idea of what's gonna have to be trimmed there. And you're not gonna wanna miss it, so check it out.
The whole goal of what we're doing right now is we got to move this up 2 inches so we can cut this bar out so that our subframe will move up 2 inches and we'll have the proper angle for our lower control arm. So I did it all in Dicom blue. I'm just going to make a line here that's square to this piece. It's in there pretty good. Now do another line going up the side of this body, square to that. All right, so now we got a line on here and a line up here. So when we move it up, we can line them up so we get the right position this way. But now also, wherever my blocks went. Oh, here they are. We also have to get the correct angle position this way. So we're gonna put a 1-2-3 block here, another 1-2-3 block here. And we're gonna scribe a line going this way across here. Right? And that line gives us this angle. And we're trying to raise this 2 inches. So when we go to raise it, we just got to bring this block up to that line and we will have it. Time to cut it all apart. Can I have one of these safety glasses up here? Cool. Thank you. Okay, now that we got this cut off, it's going from its original location here up 2 inches, which is roughly right here. So I scribed around the part. You can see right here, that's what we're gonna be cutting out. And all the way up here, we're gonna be cutting that out. And there's this bottom lip, we gotta cut that out. There we go. This should be able to come all the way up and line up. That's where about it's gonna sit. So now we'll just clean up this edge, clean this up, make this perfectly straight. Then we're gonna cut this bottom piece off and then try to flip it over and rebuild that box on the inside of the frame rail here. This is my base template that I cut out. So I made sure it was down, all the way down the low point over here on the other side, but then I'm gonna make sure it's even here, 2 inches. So this says 2 1/4 there. There's my other flat spot, so it needs to be down a little bit in the front. So there's two, so that's pretty square. Got my cardboard here. Like that, we'll cut this off of here. We're gonna cut all of this off of here.
And that should be our rough shape, you know, when you get it back in here. All right, that's my lineup line. Looks good. And we can box this back down kind of a nice angle here. All right, so we'll cut that off. A little bit of cat over here. So, sits right over there. Just like that. I think that'll work. I will take this home tonight and I will cut these out on my plasma table so that we're ready to go tomorrow. Okay guys, continuing on. We got the front frame rails trimmed out for our box top extensions. Because as you recall, we cut out the bottom. Now we're gonna recreate it on the top here. So we plasma cut out these cool little shapes and put a bunch of little spot weld holes in it so we can weld right through it to the frame rail. Pull these down, get this one tacked in place real quick. So right there. That should be about right.
You need some clamps?
I got clamps for hands, man. Tack it on here real quick. There we go. Use your hand as a clamp. A little tack there. Bam. And this frame rail isn't perfectly straight. It has kind of a little curve to it. So you gotta kind of like look and position your clamps, like whatever frame rail on whatever classic you're working on and you're doing this type of stuff. Look for those low spots and clamp in there so it sucks the metal into them. I think we got this pretty good. I like it. Go. There you go, guys. Attached. Obviously, we're gonna trim the bottom up. We are gonna grind all these smooth, and then we are gonna weld the outer seam. I don't know if we're gonna do it solid. We might just stitch weld it. We'll kind of play that by ear. Let's start tacking the top plate on. Shit. Nobody will know. Nobody will know that this one's slightly back. This one's slightly forward.
Except for all the people who just heard you say it.
Cut that out. No, that shit happens. This is kind of rough balling it.
I think it's gonna be fine. Because these aren't really dimensionally critical, right? The critical dimension is just how far.
Yeah, you know, we'll put it off of this plate and bring it over and it'll hit the edge of this plate.
Yeah.
And then we'll just grind that off and then it'll match up. It's just this one's slightly forward. This should be fine. It's like literally slightly footer. It's like not even the full thickness of the metal.
You're good.
So we'll put some tacks on the inside here. That's a shitty angle. Note to everybody on YouTube, maybe do all of your tacks on the one side before you put the other side on. Get you a better angle on your torch. But as I just demonstrated, it is still possible.
So as you guys can see, we got the boxes built onto these frame rails. So now there's the same amount of strength as factory, but instead of being below, it's above. That's allowing us to raise our subframe back up. You guys will remember from episode 2 that we used this laser cube to establish the location of our shock towers, moved them forward 3/4 of an inch for firewall clearance, and then did an offset by the correct amount for the geometry for caster and steering axis angles to get an E46 geometry on this BMW 2002 build. So we put markings on before we took these off, since we had to raise them up 2 inches to lower the car. We can now put them right back on in the exact same place. So we're gonna line them up exactly where they were. And then this is our 2-inch difference. We moved this cube up. There we go. That's gonna get us in exactly the same place with the same alignment, but 2 inches higher than the last time these were welded on. So we just got the new subframe mounts put back in, 2 inches up from before. We set the subframe in here, and like we expected, there's frame interference on the bottom. That's part of the reason why we double skinned this frame. This is a new piece of steel, but it's welded to the original frame surface. So our plan is to cut just basically between where my fingers are. And since this subframe is tapered, we're gonna be cutting about 3/4 of an inch of height out of the outer wall, but barely any off the inside wall of the frame. And then of course we'll be boxing it back in, and that box in will be tapered. And then we're all done. We're gonna be putting plates up here. We bought a chrome alloy plate to plate up here to replace the original that you saw us cut out in episode 2, the original bracing that comes down from the strut. Okay, so I know some of this didn't look like a ton of work, but I can promise you notching the frame twice actually was a lot of work. There's a lot of details and labor that goes into that. We had a notch for the subframe to go up, and then of course that brought the lower control arm rear bushing mounts, which are called lollipops, up into the frame. This area you can see where we notched the frame looks really flimsy. Trust the process. We're gonna be building boxes up above the frame here, and those are gonna be part of the integration of the engine mounts. So that's gonna come in a later episode. For now, it's just gonna be left with the frame kind of cut through. And then the exciting thing here, we didn't have to modify the steering rack or the cross member or subframe in the front from the E46 donor parts at all. So if we ever have to replace those, we actually can easily replace them with stock components from a junkyard or wherever we're gonna be getting them. Now let's check steering clearance. So we're all the way at left steering lock here. Obviously this weld seems extremely close. It doesn't technically rub, but with 7 degrees or so of caster, this wheel's gonna move back a little bit as it goes up. So we'll be clearancing this a little bit. Nothing too bad. We definitely will not be compromising the firewall in terms of pedal space, which is a huge deal. Coming from a rock crawler background, firewall trims are not something I'm afraid of, but I don't wanna cut out our pedal space. So it's pretty good. Better than we deserve. That's full lock, so we've actually got plenty of room in the front. We don't have to do any work there. And then we will be trimming our inner fenders a little bit. So this is good for clearance. Overall, really good. So we're super thrilled with the steering clearance. There's a little bit of trimming required at the firewall. We definitely expected that. The axle centerline's kicked forward about 3/4 of an inch from a stock BMW 2002. And part of that was just to gain clearance for the extreme steering angles that the E46 has and also the substantially wider tires. So we're really happy how the fitment's coming out. You're not going to want to miss episode 4. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and then check the bell to enable notifications. That way you can be the first person back here to check this build out in episode 4. We will see you guys there.